Hey, hey, Hopkinton Middle School. You're watching HMS Today with Eve Weatherhead. We've got a lot to cover, so let's dive into some segments. First up, there's a new club in this school, and it's a book club.
Hello, HMSers. Are you naturally curious? Do you find yourself wanting to read and learn about a new topic and discuss your new knowledge with others? If so, you should attend the newly formed book club on Tuesday, October 29th in room 232. Many of our selections will fall into the genre of narrative nonfiction, but fiction will always be welcomed and will make up a small portion of what we read. So come on down, expand your horizons, and meet new people with similar interests. You can even help us pick out a name. Hope to see you there.
We'll be checking in to see what's on your list, and we hope you get a lot of interest. Now, let's check in with Mr. Rockwood and a brand new Fun Fact Friday.
Yee-haw! Good morning, little partners, and welcome to another edition of Fun Fact Friday. Today I want to talk about the Alaska Purchase. The Alaska Purchase was the United States acquisition of Alaska from the Russian Empire. Alaska was formally transferred to the United States on October 18, 1867 through a treaty ratified by the United States Senate and signed by President Andrew Johnson. The purchase cost the United States $7.2 million and was ridiculed by Congress and the press at the time as Seward's folly because Secretary of State William Henry Seward was instrumental in negotiating this treaty with Russia, which ceded 586,412 square miles or 1,518,800 square kilometers of land. And even though $7.2 million seemed like a significant amount of money, it averaged out to be only 2 cents per acre for the last frontier, otherwise known as the land of the midnight sun. Well, 30 years later, in 1897, a young man, only 21 years of age, would step ashore for the first time in Juneau, Alaska, in search of his fortune in gold. I'm certainly glad he did, because he ultimately used his experiences in that territory, and they provided him with ideas when he became known as the author Jack London. Now on to the opposite side of the United States. Did you know that Maine is the only state that has a one-syllable name? Aya, it's true. Also, on this date in history, in 2009, quarterback Tom Brady threw five second-quarter touchdowns against the Tennessee Titans, an NFL record at the time for touchdown passes in one quarter. Yippee-yi-yo-ki-yay, that's it for today, folks. Make it a great day, be kind to one another, and throw yourself into an adventure book this weekend.
Thank you, Mr. Rockwood. Now, let's check in on the new question of the day. Today we're asking, what's the best Halloween candy?
Sour Patches.
Well, cheese!
Snickers.
Candy corn.
Sour Patch Kids.
Snickers and Reese's Peanut Butter Cups.
Snickers!
Kit Kats.
Kit Kats.
Gummy Bears.
Jolly Ranchers.
Kit Kats.
Skittles.
M&M's.
Candy corn or caramel M&M's.
Snickers.
Hershey's.
Snickers.
Candy corn.
Skittles.
Swedish Fish.
Twizzlers.
M&M's.
Candy pumpkins and Twizzlers.
Twix.
Hershey's chocolate covered in Twizzlers.
Sour Patch Kids or Hershey's chocolate bars.
Three Musketeers.
Skittles.
Kit Kats.
Twix.
Kit Kats and Twix.
Skittles.
Twix.
Kit Kats.
Skittles!
Now I'm hungry, and it's only homeroom. While I'm looking around for a snack, we bring you a student council update.
Hey guys!
I'm Callie.
I'm Anya.
I'm Camille.
I'm Michael.
I'm Avanya.
I'm James.
And I'm Jeep.
And we're from Student Council.
Did you hear that it's Spirit Week this month?
Oh yeah, that's always fun. When is it?
The week of October 28th.
I want to do it, but what do I do?
Well, there's Team Spirit Day, Twin Day, Pajama Day, and Decades Day.
And don't forget Halloween Day, but don't wear your costumes.
Right. Show your spirit by wearing Halloween colors like orange and black or spooky accessories or clothes.
You know I'm doing that.
Don't miss out on the fun.
And, just to convince you, the grade that shows the most spirit gets music at lunch.
Music!
Cool. It's time to show your stuff, HMS. All right, let's roll the birthday scroll. Happy Happy birthday, everybody. Now, have you ever asked?
Why is that?
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 Well, we're starting a new segment here. And if you see something at HMS that puzzles you, just email us and we'll look into it. Lastly, it's have you seen this? We know last week was a bit tough, but we did get a correct answer. Good job, Madeline Scofield. Mrs. McBride has a prize for you in the main office. For the rest of you, this is a picture of somewhere in the school. Have you seen this? Email us where it is, and from the correct responses, we'll pick a winner for a candy-filled water bottle. And that's a wrap. See everything HMSTV on our website, hmst.today, and tell us everything at hmstv@hillers.org. This week, we have a new poll, so visit our website and give us an answer. Thanks for watching. You're watching HMSTV. TV today. We'll be checking in to see what's on our on your list. Sorry.
And we hope you get
sorry. Just email us and we'll look into it. This week we have a new pool. So visit our website.